many people go to the dentist every 6 months to maintain proper health. When they get their teeth cleaned, we use a code that is called a prophylaxis, which the term itself means to prevent. What we're trying to do is prevent periodontal disease. Periodontal disease is actually screened for and diagnosed by using what is called the periodontal probe. It's an instrument that allows us to see the depths of the pockets that surround our teeth. Pockets are normal, so if you have a pocket depth of 2 or 3 millimeters, that is considered normal and cleansable. As soon as we start to get a pocket depth of 4 and above, we are dealing with inflammation. 4 is probably indication of a reversible stage of periodontal disease called gingivitis. It's fairly common and an early sign. If we can get to it early, this is reversible and we can probably prevent bone loss. As soon as you start having a probing depth of around 5 to 6 millimeters is when we are starting to lose bone around the teeth. If left untreated, then the bone loss around the teeth can lead to tooth loss. Now, one thing that is common, but I think is a misnomer, is when they call it a deep cleaning. In my office, we try not to use the term deep cleaning because it honestly, it is a euphemism for how serious of a condition it truly is. It's not a decision between a regular cleaning and a deep cleaning, similar to a car wash where we've got the regular car wash and the deluxe. What we're really trying to do is deal with a bacterial infection. This isn't a matter of a buildup of tartar or calculus, as we call it in the industry. It is actually a biofilm. We are dealing with bacteria and different strains of bacteria. The bacteria that we're trying to fight against are not the normal type of bacteria that are found in a healthy mouth. Now, our mouth is actually fairly filthy, full of many different types of bacteria. Once the pocket depths reach a certain depth, the bacteria that are found in there are different than what we find in a healthy mouth. We're dealing with Porphyromonas gingivalis, Actinomyces, spirochetes, different types of bacteria that have a far-reaching effect and not just in our mouth. If you consider the deep ocean, the type of fish that we find in shallow water is much different than the type of fish that we find in the deep, dark reaches of the ocean. Similarly, the types of bacteria that are in the deep pockets are different and more destructive. Now, usually when we are dealing with periodontal therapy, this is the method that we do to treat periodontal disease, it's not something that's done in usually a single visit. There usually is a range of 2 to 4 visits. The other thing that's misunderstood is the periodontal disease is cyclic. So if you have periodontal therapy once, it's not something you do once in your lifetime. You will probably have to have therapy again on more than one occasion. The number of years between your therapy sessions is up to you. If you are not very good at home with your home care and your homework, then it's possible that you would need to do periodontal therapy more frequently. It's more common, though, that if you're doing your part and we're doing our part, we get to see you every 3 months and you're taking care of yourself at home, then usually the periods of dormancy and activity are spread out, maybe between 3 to 5 years on average, and in some cases upwards to 7 years. But it's not unusual if we diagnose periodontal disease that you'll have to have periodontal therapy on more than one occasion. Now, why is it important for us to treat your periodontal disease? I've already mentioned that one problem would be loss of teeth. There is also research that links a lot of systemic issues with our oral health. Now, many dentists will debate whether there's causation versus correlation, but the fact remains that there's quite a significant relationship between our oral health and our systemic health. A good reference for people to read and learn about this is a book called The Beat the Heart Attack Gene by Bale and Donin. It can be found on Amazon or probably your local bookstore. Even many physicians are recognizing the importance of our oral health. Many OBs are recommending that their patients during pregnancy see their dentist on more than one occasion, make sure that the developing baby is as healthy as possible. Now, once there's a diagnosis of periodontal disease, it's very important that it be treated. In my office, you have an option to treat the disease in my office or a referral to a periodontist. But to decline periodontal therapy in the presence of periodontal disease is not an option in my office and may not be an option in yours. Now, if it's an early stage of periodontal disease, gingivitis or very early, we might be a little bit more flexible. But if you've got significant bone loss, significant deposits of calculus and such, then it's important that the disease is treated. Some offices will even have people sign papers saying that they understand the periodontal disease is present and declining to have treatment. In my office, that is not an option.